Hey guys, welcome back to another Clash Royale video, and today we're gonna be taking a look at the brand new card, the Electro Giant, coming soon in Clash Royale, and you can already see it right here in all of its glory, guys. It is a new win condition in Clash Royale. Look at how big that card is. Now, notice how when it gets to the tower, it goes in and attacks it like a regular giant does. However, pay attention to the princess. Notice how whenever she attacks the Electro Giant, she gets zapped herself. The unique mechanic with the Electro Giant is it has a counterattack. Anything that attacks it within a certain radius gets zapped back. So I'm going to go ahead here and actually mirror the Electro Giant on the left-hand side of the arena. And pay attention to that little blue radius around the Electro Giant. Anything in that circle that attacks it will get zapped. However, if the unit is outside of that circle and attacks it, it will not get zapped. So, you can still use ranged units outside of the circle to attack it. However, what you can't do is use an Inferno Tower. Look at this. Inferno Tower goes down, locks onto it, but now, once within the radius, the Inferno Tower gets zapped and reset. So the Inferno Tower cannot destroy an Electro Giant unless you keep the E-Giant out of the tower range. But honestly, guys, a super cool new card coming to Clash Royale. And honestly, new win condition, new mechanics, just honestly, in my opinion, freaking awesome. Now watch this. The other cool thing with the Electro Giant, we'll dive into the stats here in a moment, is defense. Now watch this. We're going to go Skarmy here on the right side of the arena. Watch this. We're going to go E-Giant down here. Look at this. The skeletons all go down as they attack the Electro Giant. So, the interesting thing here is it offers a bit of versatility on offense and defense. Similar to how you can use like a Goblin Giant on defense. This thing is very, very cool as well. Now, you might be thinking, Shane, Sparky. Is this hard counter Sparky? Well, no. Because look at this. Number one, they only get zapped when they attack. And number two, Sparky has range and typically stays outside of the range. Even if it were in the range, it still doesn't get zapped until attacking. So the Sparky is not hard countered at all by the Electro Giant. I'm going to let my tower go down here, if I can. Is that this? There we go. Cool. So I want to show you a few more things with the Electro Giant. Most notably is going to be the Minion Horde over here. And we'll kind of dive into some stats in a moment here. But watch this right here. Inferno Dragon. Inferno Dragon normally hard counters tanks like giants, RGs, golems, etc. Watch this. Inferno Dragon goes in there, starts melting away, but then boom, gets reset and literally does nothing. Let's go ahead and use Minion Horde here. Minion Horde goes down, starts attacking. Oh no, it's all getting zapped. Minion Horde gets annihilated as well, guys. Look at that. Absolutely positive. Let's use skeletons. Skeletons kill the E-Giant, please. No, my skeletons are dead. Literally, the counter-attacking ability of the Electro Giant is absolutely insane. And honestly, going to be one of my favorite cards in this game. It is absurd. Now, let's go ahead and try a tried-and-true tested counter-attack or defending unit, the P.E.K.K.A. How does the P.E.K.K.A. do against an Electro Giant right here? Watch this. P.E.K.K.A. goes in, smacks it, gets zapped, but doesn't do a whole lot. And look at this. It actually does a decent amount of work of destroying the Electro Giant before it gets to the tower. However, the interesting thing there is that the zap from the E-Giant will reset the targeting of the P.E.K.K.A. So, that's important because if your opponent, for example, is using an E-Giant and you have a P.E.K.K.A., your P.E.K.K.A. might retarget to units that are behind the Electro Giant. Cool? So that is a very, very interesting kind of mechanic. We're going to try one more time right here. Let's go double. Oh, no, we don't have Mirror. Alright, E-Giant for the one right here. We're going to defend it with a Skarmy. We'll defend it with an Infernal Dragon and an Infernal Tower. Look at this. they both just keep... Look at this. The double Infernos are no match for the Electro Giant. It clears its way through and the Zaspel does damage as well. Tower goes down. The E-Giant didn't even hit the tower at all. The tower destroyed herself. She attacked the Electro Giant and got zapped and got destroyed. It is absolutely insane, guys. I freaking love this card. So I know what you guys are thinking right now. Shane, the Electro Giant looks absurdly overpowered. How is that anywhere close to being balanced? Well, here's the thing. It is an 8 elixir cost card, which is the equivalent elixir cost of a golem. All right? Now, take a look at the health. The Electro Giant actually has, this is turning standard, less health than a regular giant. So 3,192 health at tournament standard. A regular giant has 3,275, so about 100 more health than the Electro Giant. The Golem, for the same 8 elixir cost, has 4,256 health, so 1,100 more health than the Electro Giant. And, of course, obviously, it spawns out 2 of the Golemites as well, which each have 800 health as well. So that's about a total of, like, what, 3,000 almost more health than the Electro Giant with the Golem. So there is that downside. It is a very, very expensive card. However, keep in mind that you can often get elixir value for it because of the zap counterattack, destroying your opponent's units, and obviously clearing the way through things like Infernal Dragons, Infernal Towers, and stuff like that. But do keep in mind, guys, that the health is significantly lower than a golem, and even less than that of a giant. Now, the damage as well, guys, is less than a regular giant as well. 75 damage per second at tournament standard, whereas a regular giant is 140. So the regular giant is almost double the damage per second of the Electro Giant. However, that does not factor in the zap damage. You saw previously that the Princess Tower was also getting zapped whenever she attacked, and that damage adds up as well. So if you add the zap damage in to the regular damage of the Electro Giant, obviously it's insane, and it only compounds further if they have Swarm or just more units overall being zapped as well, guys. It is going to be an absolutely insane card in Clash Royale. All right, guys, I want to show you a couple more things with the Electro Giant in battle over here. Check this out. If I drop down a massive swarm of units, E-Giant goes down. Look at this. Like, yeah, it takes a ton of damage in the process, but everything gets wiped out, and now we have a counter push. Now, obviously, that was 8 elixir, which is an insane elixir commitment, but just the ability to use it on defense to destroy things, or just even for that reset factor as well, is going to be insane. Like, look at this right here. E-Giant gets the tower. Tower retargets to the Ice Golem. The Ice Golem is now tanking for the Electro Giant because of the zap mechanic. Resetting the Princess Tower to the Ice Golem just destroys it. There's so many cool things you can do with this E-Giant, guys. It is absolutely absurd. Now, pay attention right here to both towers. Notice how the Princess Tower on the right-hand side is not getting zapped? That's because she is outside of the radius, whatever you want to call it. That kind of zap radius. If you're outside of that zap radius, you do not get zapped when you attack. All right, just to demonstrate this a bit further here, guys, let's go ahead and use a couple of ranged units against the Electro Giant. And notice how the Firecracker is not getting zapped. The Dark Goblin will not get zapped. The Skeletons will. We can use Archers out here, outside of the radius, and nothing is being zapped. So obviously, there's going to be some strategy involved in how do you counter it, right? You got to place your units outside of it, or it just can't be anything too fragile. Skeletons, Goblins, Minions, Bats, stuff like that, don't use it inside the radius. They'll get destroyed pretty easily. If it's a Knight or a Mini P.E.K.K.A. or something like that, obviously, they're more tankier, and they won't mind the zap spell as badly, so you can kind of use those if you will. All right, guys and girls, jumping in here to some actual gameplay, some actual battles, or a actual battle with the Electro Giant, because all of that stuff is all good in theory, but how does it actually perform in an actual battle? That's what we all really want to know. So let's go ahead, throw it in here, guys, see how we can do. We got a Barbarian Bear left one. He's going to get one swing to the tower. He's going to go E-Wizard for that, actually, which I'm definitely okay with. Magic Archer here for this. I tried to throw in a few rangers on my deck so that way they can outrange the E-Giant. Boom, there we go. Nice, nice, nice. And okay, I might have to go Fireball here. I actually did not think about air defense at all. So I'm going to have to go E-Giant and then Ice Spirit it. There we go. All right, cool. Nice little Nadal there. I respect that. I respect that. The Nadal is actually going to be a great card with the E-Giant. Because if you Nadal everything like, if they try and put their units around it, like out of range, and then all of a sudden you NATO everything together into the giant, the E-Giant, like radius, now they're all getting zapped, right? So that's kind of going to be kind of cool. I'm going to ignore that barbell left lane. See how that goes. I'm going to go E-Giant in front of this, Jess. And then I want to get, so the bats will get annihilated by the E-Giant. Look at this, look at this. Ready? Boom, they all just get destroyed. Ay, ay, ay. Yikes. Come on, baby. Nice, there we go. So this Sparky should take care of the tower. E-Giant goes in and zaps a few things. Barbarian gets annihilated by the Sparky as well. So the E-Giant destroying the bats there on that push, that's absolutely insane, dude. Absolutely, positively insane. I actually think Goblin Giant's going to be useless after this giant comes out. Because it's basically just better. So, I gotta be careful here. So I think he might go E-Giant Balloon Rage. Which, like, literally, how do I stop that? Okay. He rages it up. We're gonna use our stuff outside of the range here. But look at this. It rages it up. Get some respectable tower damage done. The thing is with that E-Giant, like, it slows the attack speed of everything attacking it. Doesn't matter what you have, everything attack speed gets slowed. Like, the faster your unit is, the more it gets stunned. So if you have, like, a Lumberjack, super fast attack speed, it just gets, slowed perpetually. Right? One of these. Nice. I blocked that, fishy boy. Purple this back. No, balloon hits. Yikes, bro. Is that enough to kill it? 194 health. Nadal goes down. We need to pick a left lane. Let's go this here. Goblin Giant in front. All right. So, E-Giant, I got to say, definitely a fan. I think it's a really, really cool card. And I'm really looking forward to it in Clash Royale, guys. Yeah. Huge thumbs up from me. Dark Prince for Dark Prince over here. They shall cancel out. And I don't think I'm going to go... I'm not going to do anything to support that. It's not like a regular giant that you just drop in front of counter pushes. It is 80 elixir, so that has to play a factor in your decision making. Alright. Let's do this. And then Lumberjack as well. Yo, it slows everything down so much. Because of the zap. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Like, look. Wow. That is absurd, bro. Alright, Mega Minion here. Gets Rage Up, kills the Barbarian. Alright, cool. Dude, the faster units attack, the more they get zapped. That is absolutely absurd. So, I'm gonna go E-Giant left lane here. We'll try and go for a bigger push. We'll kind of see how it goes. I don't have a heavy spell to punish that pump, unfortunately. So we'll kind of see how that goes, but... I'm gonna go a regular Dark Prince in front. To soak that charge. I wish I had a heavy spell right now. Fireball or lightning spell would be ideal. Nails that together. Check it out. Yo, what was that? That was a weird glitch. Just kind of like zap the opposite lane there. He's gonna go one more pump right here though. Easy. Easy pump time. Goblin Cage here. We're in trouble, guys. He's got two pumps down. We can't even get a giant in front of that because it's so expensive. Normally with a regular giant, you can sneak one in front on those kind of plays. But not in that scenario. Not in that scenario at all. Alright, I guarantee he's going to go. Oh, same lane. Okay. I was going to expect a giant this lane. But that's okay. I like his pairing it up with the E-Dragon for some extra stunnage. It's a good idea. This... Pull everything together. Check it out, boys. Look at this. The E-Giant and the E-Dragon are going to be a great combo together, dude. I think at least. Dude, that's insane. Good game. Well played, broski. Guys, the Electro-Giant is insanely, I dare say, it's strong. Yeah, it's 8 elixir, but the value you get is almost guaranteed. Most of the time. I think it's going to be a great card in Clash Royale, and I'm super looking forward to it. That was cool. Anyways, guys and girls, that is all the information so far on the Electro Giant. Let me know your thoughts down below. Are you as excited as I am for this new card? Personally, I think it's the coolest new card out of 2020, and honestly, one of the coolest cards in the entire game. I am freaking excited for it. And the other cool thing, guys, is this is the first of two new cards coming in Season 16, Shocktober of Clash Royale, guys. So make sure you stay tuned to the channel for any more information as soon as I'm able to post it, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you do, make sure to leave a like, guys. Thank you for watching. We shall see you in the next one.